Hello, my dear children. Today, let us discuss 10th Biology, Chapter 1, Nutrition. This is Food Supplying System. In the name itself, the meaning is very clear. Procurement of nutrients is called nutrition. So, we need food materials to get energy. Every individual have to get energy. So that energy will be given by the food materials such as carbohydrates, proteins, fats, etc. These food materials are produced by the plants only. Green plants. The green plants are having the capability to produce the food materials by means of a process. That process is very important, life process. Here I would like to explain what is life and what are life processes. Life is a typical type of character. It has to be exhibited by the individual. The feelings, the sensations, other kind of physiological activities, anatomical activities, functional activities, like that, all these activities are segregated and called a simple word called stimulus. Stimulus is nothing but a character by which you can respond to the changes that are happening in the environment. If the stimulus is there, definitely response will be there. If the stimulus is not there, response will not be. Let me take one example. One small bench is there, made up of wood or plastic or plywood. You can beat the bench, it never feels the pain. You can take the individual, small human beings or animals. You can pitch something, they will feel pain. If winter season is there, they will feel cold. The bench may not feel cold. That is called, you know, stimulus and response. Okay? Sensations are very important to create stimuli. On the basis of the stimuli, responses will be created. And this phenomenon is called life process. These life processes are very important in living organisms. The fundamental life processes are categorized into two. One is anabolic activity and another one is catabolic activity. Anabolic activity means smaller molecules are constructed to form a larger molecule. That is called anabolic activity. Let me give one example to you. Carbon dioxide is very small. Oxygen is very small. These two molecules are united one another and forms into carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide is little bit bigger than carbon and oxygen. That is called anabolic activity. The sequential things are called anabolic reactions, and total phenomenon is called anabolism. Then let me move to catabolism. It is a destructive activity. Larger molecule destructed into smaller molecules. Let me take one example. Carbohydrate, it is a larger molecule, C6H12O6. It destructed into amino acids, smaller molecules. This is called catabolism. So, in life processes, what is actually happening? Anabolism replaced by catabolism and catabolism replaced by anabolism. Continuously, this process is going on. Altogether, both anabolic activity and catabolic activity is called metabolic activity. This phenomenon is called metabolism. Right? So if the metabolism should be there, definitely the organisms will expose to show the life processes such as photosynthesis, respiration, nutrition, excretion, control and coordination, and the last one is reproduction. Okay, these are the major life processes. So life based on plants, because they are producing the food materials. We are unable to produce the food materials because we don't have green pigment. The plants got green pigment, that is called chlorophyll. Okay, then the capability of producing food materials by the plants, so that's why the plants are called autotrophs. We as human beings, and animals are there, and little insects and other things are there, and these are unable to produce their own food materials, they depended on plants, so they are called heterotrophs. So in our first page we can very clearly see that autotrophs are there and heterotrophs are there. The production of food materials by the plants is called autotrophic nutrition, and the production of food materials involved in a process, that process is called photosynthesis. It is a typical, or you can say complex, photochemical reaction. Let me explain this. Photo means light. Synthesis means adding the molecules, chemically combining and recombining. And it is a chemical reaction. So photosynthesis is nothing but a complex photochemical reaction. This complexity is very high, and it is a gift given by the nature to the living organisms. By means of that only we can able to get food materials. So many experiments are done by the scientists to show or to know how the plants are able to produce the food materials. So Van Niel in 1931, according to his prediction, I am using the word predictions, so intelligent guess. So his prediction is that each molecule of carbohydrate will be produced by carbon dioxide, water, and these two small inorganic materials are chemically combined in the presence of light and chlorophyll under. So according to his prediction, his thesis, so one equation is given in the textbook, page number 2. But when you people say the carbohydrate chemical equation is C6H12O6, this chemical reaction is not balancing. As you know, the chemical reaction should be balanced. That means reactants and products are there, equilibrium should be there. So on the basis of that particular thing, later Robert Hill, he showed very clearly that oxygen is liberated. Previously Van Niel is unable to prove that oxygen is liberated. Whenever Robert Hill invented the light reaction particularly, so the light reaction is also called as Hill reaction, he reframed the chemical equation into an advanced form, that is 6 molecules of carbon dioxide, 12 molecules of water added with each other in the presence of light and chlorophyll, and to produce C6H12O6, that is glucose, and 6 molecules of water released and 6 molecules of oxygen released. So the plants are producing oxygen, they are using the carbon dioxide that is available in the environment, and they are releasing oxygen. Not only that, they are producing the food materials in the form of glucose, and this glucose is stored in various parts of the plant. It may be stored in leaves, it may be stored in flowers, stem, branches, roots. We are consuming all these things. Leafy vegetables we are taking, tubers we are taking, flowers, cauliflower, etc. we are taking, fruits we are taking, seeds also sometimes, just like badam, pista and cashew and groundnuts, etc., etc. Millets, all these are seeds, including oryza sativa, that is rice. So they are storing their food materials, they are using little and they are giving us more. So that's why we have to respect the plants, respect the nature. Without them, we don't have the chance to get food materials, and we don't have the chance to get oxygen. Then, on the basis of this experiment or this equation, chemical equation, let us try to see the definition of the photosynthesis. If it is possible, please write. I will say slowly. Photosynthesis is a complex photochemical reaction in which simple inorganic substances like carbon dioxide and water chemically combine in the presence of light and chlorophyll to form glucose, water and oxygen. This is called the definition of photosynthesis. And just now only I said the chemical equation. If you see the chemical equation, so face to face I am saying this view. So on my left I have some elements, on my right I have some elements. So these are, that means left side are reactants and right side are products. Here two reactants are there. One is carbon dioxide, another one is water. On the other side, you have glucose, water, and oxygen. So, reactants and products are very clear, right? So, in the middle, you have number of small intermediate products are also there. We will not consider that one because just you people are 10th class. If you go to BSc or MSc Fundamental Sciences and you know the physiology lessons, there you can say very detailed reaction for 1 year. Photosynthesis is very beautiful chapter. And let me say, introduce one word called factor. Factor is nothing but an element which is essential to conduct the reaction. Let me give one example. If you want to make a cup of coffee, you need coffee powder, milk, vessel, stove, sugar, cup with saucer or cup or glass, and 1 teaspoon. All these are factors. Without coffee powder, you can't prepare coffee. Without milk, you can prepare black coffee. So, in that case, you need water instead of milk. Then, in that case, the water will be a factor. If you are taking milk, the milk will be a factor. Sugar. And then what about cup? Without cup you can't drink. It is not possible by taking coffee in our hands and drink like this. The cup is also very important. So these are factors. In the same way, in the photosynthesis, by means of observing the chemical equation, you can identify the factors. There are 4 factors. One is carbon dioxide, another one is water, The next one is sunlight. The last one is chlorophyll. Let me repeat my statement once again. There are four factors: carbon dioxide, water, light, and chlorophyll. So, once again, the factors are two types. On the basis of their availability, external factors and internal factors. External factors means, in the name itself, meaning is there, the factors that are available from the outside sources. Internal factors means the factors that are available in the plant, within the plant. So it is very clear to you, so two external factors are there and two internal factors are there. Light is external factor, which is coming from the sun, and carbon dioxide is obviously available in the environment. Then internal factor, chlorophyll, it is there in the leaf itself. Leaf and tie, all green plants of the plant contain chlorophyll, and the plant is taking water from the ground, so the water is also available in the plant. Okay, so these four factors, without these four factors, there is no possibility of photosynthesis. For this particular purpose, we have to conduct some experiments. Carbon dioxide is essential for the process of photosynthesis, one experiment. And light is essential, without light there is no question of photosynthesis, second experiment. And chlorophyll is essential for the process of photosynthesis, third experiment. And last one, oxygen released during the process of photosynthesis. So these four experiments. Okay, tomorrow we will see one experiment after another experiment. Basically they are called lab activities. Okay children, let me recall what are the important key concepts that we learned today. The first one, we know what are anabolic activities and what are catabolic activities. We also discussed anabolism and catabolism, metabolism. We know what are autotrophs and we know what are heterotrophs. We know the definition of the word photosynthesis and the chemical equation of photosynthesis. We know what are the reactants of the reaction and what are the products of the reaction. And the last one is factors, types of factors, external factors and internal factors. Okay, so very special circumstances lo we are trying to give some kind of conceptual clarity to you people with the help of our education department, Bhadradri Kottagudem, DEO sir and DCED sir and assistant commissioner for government examinations. These people are planning these kind of lessons to you. So we are trying to give our level best to you people. So getting conceptual understanding is very important, children. Try to read the lesson, page number 1, 2 and 3. Zero half chapter number. Okay, thank you.